Little bit of blue sky. A window in the weather. Just had half a millimetre of rain. Had a millimetre this morning at sunrise. After the driveway haven't been a mud pie for 2 weeks. Working through the weather window. Here comes load number 6. Second load today, the final load. Bringing it to 24 tonnes of fill for the yurt pad. That's the state of the art.
We've got more rain coming.
Oh yeah, there's more rain for the next week.
Yeah, right, I heard it, but I didn't want to believe it.
Yeah, I didn't want to believe it either. I can hardly believe we're getting in through the weather window with this.
Yeah, I'm hearing you now. It's been pretty lucky at first. Or fortunate.
Yeah.
Done.
Almost. Now we just got to spread it out. Yeah, 24 tonnes looks a lot better than 16 did. There we go, 24 tonnes of fill for the pad. Okay, we're going to brighten up. Cool. Okay. Not quite job done because before it rains, somebody has to rake that flat and try to level it by hand with a rake and a rake hoe. I wonder who that's going to be. Okay. Not perfect, but better. Yeah, not terribly bad, not perfect, but I've spent an hour and a half on the Rako. And there's 20 millimeters forecast for here. More or less as a mini mum. And Maybe it's lazy, but I think that's kind of almost an elegant sufficiency as far as I can see. I think a 6 meter diameter yurt should sit on that. It won't be perfectly flat unless somebody goes in there and puts in more work, and maybe I'll do that on another day after we see what some rain has done to level the proceedings. No doubt it will shrink vertically. It won't stay that high. But to fill it all the way to the top was going to be about another 4 loads. And it's 35 kilometres to the quarry, so that's like a 70k round trip. So it's not cheap. It's not cheap. And the extra 2 loads was not in the original budget. So yeah, there we go. Warbles on a lot to YouTube. The pad is in place, more or less, kind of sort of thing, unless somebody wants to make it better. Ciao.